we work with you basically until you're happy.
Will you separately buy these different services?
Yeah, so all of the services we offer are a la carte. Okay. So we work with authors who will do everything with us. You'll see all the different services. But we work with many authors. Probably most of our authors don't do everything. Some will come and just have us do editing, and then they'll go somewhere else, and some will have us do a cover. So yeah, so they're all a la carte. And so with you can provide your own images. We're flexible. You'll hear me say that a lot from here on out, probably.
Hello?
Yes, I'm sorry.
If all of these services one were to do elsewhere, mm-hmm. then how would your company make money?
That is a good question, and that is one we get a lot. How does your company make money? To
well, I can say you hired you for all those services, but
right.
we didn't.
Well, so the answer I give, because that is one we get a lot, is that we, because of the, I described how I got started in the traditional publishing world and Chrysler Publishing, over these years, we've developed a great infrastructure of efficiency and relatively low overhead, and we can create books and make them available at a low cost. So, and for us to add any book or 10 books or 100 books into our system, it doesn't take too much extra labor. So that's how we're able to operate without taking anything on the back end. So we do charge for our upfront fees. So if someone comes to us for just the cover, they pay $500, $499, and we create that, and then they can go elsewhere, and we have a margin.
Don't understand if they didn't get anything from you.
Oh, if they don't get anything from us?
Yeah, they would, in other words, you're saying an author would have to buy some of your services in order to be
okay.
accepted, right?
Can you repeat the question, please?
The question, I think I understand what she's saying. I think what she's saying is, well, what if someone just wants to use your distribution services and get onto all these websites, have their book listed there, but they've already got the cover design, they've already done everything,
yeah.
and so they're not hiring you for any services. Well, we do have an option for that, and we do charge for that. And I'll actually show it on the next two slides or so. We call it a distribution-only option. So if someone comes to us and they already have all of their files done, ready to go, don't need anything, and they want us to do the distribution, royalty reporting.
Well, you do the printing, too.
And the printing, yes. So we charge a fee for that. If you want to use us just to print your book, I would tell you probably, well, no, we've done that for other people. We've done that. We generally don't sort of advertise that, but we've done it. So our printing cost is very, very reasonable. Our quality is better than places like Spark and CreateSpace. And so that's something we do for our print edition authors. We offer paperback and hardcover printing, and I'll get to those in just a sec. Just want to make sure I'm on time. So, okay, we do completely customized. This is our print edition layout and distribution service. The $5.99, you can read on here what you get. This is if you come to us and you want us to create a paperback or hardcover book for you. So we do the layout, we do the formatting, we work with you, we don't charge extra for graphics, we give you 4 free copies. And then the distribution part is then we make it available for sale everywhere. And we also do printing for our authors. So, and we do that last point there is we do drop shipping for our authors. So we will work with people who have their own websites and platforms, and we will fulfill their orders for them.
Do you require ISBN?
We do not. Great question. So you can come to us with your own ISBN, but it is included in this price. We would give you an ISBN under the gate when you sign up here.
Drop?
Yes.
When you do that, does the book show up on Amazon or anything as a press as a publisher?
That is a really good question. The question is, if we're publishing you, what shows up as your publisher? Does Gatekeeper Press show up as your publisher? And we, by default, it would. We have authors, we have what we call an imprint setup fee, $50, 50. If you would like to use your own publisher name. So we have a lot of people that do that. For authors that we work with, or publishers that we work with who do more than one book, we waive that fee. So we do a whole lot of books for other publishing companies that you, it doesn't show up as Gatekeeper Press. And I see a question here.
Can you, you say that your production quality is higher than Spark LSI? In my experience, that wouldn't be much of a threshold to jump on. Unfortunately. But I'm wondering, can you do full color interiors?
Yes, we do full color interiors. We do hardcovers. We do paperbacks. When you do a full color interior, we use a nicer, thicker stock of paper, so there's no bleed through. So yes, and also we, because we're a relatively small company. By the way, did I mention we're in Ohio, Columbus, Ohio? So it's nice to be here in February. I'm staying here for a week too. So, but so yes, we do that. We offer a whole lot of printing options. And this is, again, we do paperback and hardcover here. So yes, I'm sorry. Please. We can do that for you. We do a custom quote if someone wants to do a bulk print run.
Yeah.
But to be honest, you'd be better off going to, because we would just actually work with an offset printer.
Yeah.
And so you'd be better off going direct. But we would refer you and say, go check out this company, that company. And I saw a hand over here.
What are your annual revenues?
For authors?
For your company?
I mean, that's proprietary. It's worth asking, I guess. But I can say this is, we are growing very, very fast. We are getting our name out there, and people, we're doing okay.
We do have about 10 minutes left.
Okay.
Yeah. What's the cost for the author to buy the book, and how would that be comparable to CreateSpace, Engelsbart, and what would the retail be comparable?
Sure. The question is basically about printing costs. What does an author have to pay? So it's contingent on the page count, much like anywhere else. We have a calculator on our site, so our website is gatekeeperpress.com. If you play around on there, we've got a printing cost calculator. We also have a royalty calculator for print edition, similar to what you'd see on those other sites. In terms of how the price compares to others, it's very comparable. I think in some cases, depending on the trim size and whether you're getting color interior, it will be a little more or a little less expensive, but it's right at the same level. We ship faster. I think that's what I was about to be saying. Is that we're a relatively small company, so we have flexibility to move things fast as you need. I'll just quickly go through the end of my slides so we can do more questions. So I know that's usually the best part of it. So we do ebook conversion and distribution. So for $299, we will create your ebook file, and we will make it available for sale everywhere. We don't require pre-formatting. You can have as many graphics and anything in there. This price currently includes putting enhancements in or a fixed layout style. Again, you earn all of your proceeds and have all of your control. This price includes an ISBN if you need one. And your book will be available pretty much everywhere, including places like Overdrive, libraries, sellers, and elsewhere. I didn't hear anyone say they do children's books here. Oh, okay, I just didn't hear what you think. But so we do illustrations too, and we do a whole range of styles, as you can see here. And right now, this price is going to be changing soon. We've just listed at $150 per illustration, but as you can even see up here, some are more complex than others. What we are likely to switch to soon is a tiered pricing. But the illustrations has been very popular, and we can do pretty much any style.
The author own the copyrights to those?
The author does, yes. So what we create, the question is, does the author own the copyrights? Not only does the author own the copyrights to anything, illustrations we do, but everything we create for you is yours. So we lay your book out and created an InDesign file and a cover file and PDFs. It's all yours. And there's no requirement to stay with us to continue distributing your book. I didn't mention before, but we've had authors, I think it's one of my last slides here, that we've had authors who've done very well, and they've been solicited by traditional publishers, and they say, well, I want to go and do that. Because the book is their right, they just say, you just email us and say, please stop selling my book, I'm going to go take it here, and then we do, and all the files are yours. Unlike many places that try to charge you and make it a nightmare. Yes, sir?
When an author wants to revise a book in your system, can the author just write over the file, or is there a new charge
et cetera?
Very good question. We do charge what we call content change fees after the submission of a manuscript, and this is something to be mindful of. We try as hard as we can throughout the process. We will charge you if we have to go back into your file and make adjustments. It's almost inevitable. Most people catch something, and sometimes we'll waive the fee if we're feeling nice. But no, it takes labor to go in and change it and to re-upload and rebroadcast out to all these different places. So we do. We charge, it starts at, if it's 1 to 9 changes, it's a $40 fee. And then it tiers up from there, 10 to 25 changes, it's a $65 fee. So we do. And so be careful there. Yes?
Is there a number, a minimum number of illustrations, and does the author get the copyright?
Yeah, the author does get the copyright. There is no minimum number. We've worked with people who've done one. This top right one, that was a cover illustration. Just got that one illustration. Yes, sir.
May we please see the slide for distribution only?
I don't have a slide for distribution only, but I can do my best to tell you what it is. So if it's a print edition book, paperback or hardcover, we charge $349 to do that. And we do get people who will sign up for this. Because our distribution can be helpful, we aggregate for you. So $349 is for paper print edition distribution only. Ebook we do $249.
And what for both?
No, the ebook is $249 to do the distribution of the ebook only, and then if you want to do print edition distribution only, that's $349.
And is there a combined price?
We don't have one. We don't have that right now, but. We can be flexible. We can work with you.
What makes sense for somebody who's already produced something on CreateSpace to then go to you for other distribution?
The question is, if you've published with CreateSpace, does it make sense to switch to us? And we have worked with a lot of people come to us from CreateSpace, from Ingram Spark, from some of the other companies. And my answer is, lawyerly, it depends. Because if you're already on CreateSpace and you're selling most of your books on Amazon, then you'd have to look at a decision, well, is it worth it for you to pay $349 to come to us? Well, there are benefits, a lot of benefits to our distribution over CreateSpace. For example, our authors earn a little bit more money per sale on non-Amazon sites. You get access to this author manager. Our quality of our books is a little better to when you order copies from us. But if you think you can make back that investment of $349 for the benefits we offer them, that's...
And what I'm thinking about is I have a number of clients who basically have done their books on CreateSpace because they wanted to sell to local businesses, and now they think that they have a larger market. So it might make sense. They haven't sold a lot to CreateSpace.
You know, we cannot hear you back here.
Okay. So she was just mentioning that she works with a lot of people who publish on CreateSpace and that they may have outgrown CreateSpace. And so... would it be beneficial for them to come to Gatekeeper Press? One of the benefits for someone like that goes back to the question about a publisher name and imprint. When you publish through CreateSpace, if I'm not mistaken, I think it says published by CreateSpace.
Then you get the free one, yeah.
Oh, okay, all right.
You can use your own ISBN.
So you can use your own ISBN, okay.
And I believe you can take the same ISBN for paperback from Ingram Spark and do on CreateSpace.
Yes, that you can do, because it's your ISBN, you own it.
Yeah.
Yes. Five, okay. All right. I'm going to quickly just mention a few successes and some challenges, and then we'll do some questions along with the end. But basically, we've had a USA Today bestseller. We've had solicitations from traditional publishers. We've had authors reviewed in major publications all over the place. A couple notable things that just happened in the last few weeks was one of our books was listed as a best book of 2017 for by the Boston Globe. Barnes & Noble had a top 20 staff favorite pick. We have, because we are, our name is listed on a lot of the books that we publish, we get solicitations. We just send them right off to you as the author. For foreign rights, translation rights, even dramatic rights, a play was done with one of our books. Challenges, we sort of talked about a lot of them. Getting your book known in front of people that may want to buy it, getting picked up into brick and mortar stores. And then the question about content changes, that's a challenge too. We don't want to charge you to do those changes. We sort of have to because it takes time. But that, come prepared as best you can. And a do your homework slide, just whether you work with, whoever you work with, whether you work with a company who will do all this stuff for you, or whether you work with an individual editor, just always do your work. In this industry, there's horror stories that we hear. If you took a look at our testimonials page, you'd see some people write stuff. They say they come from other places and have had terrible experiences.
Do they list the names of the terrible experiences?
I don't know if they're listed there. I don't know if I'm comfortable saying that here, but if you want to like talk to me afterwards, I'll do it. Because there are some that are better than others, but and we do offer a satisfaction guarantee. If you just aren't happy, we give you all your money back and not hesitate. We are offering a 10% discount on any of our services. I didn't include a coupon code though, so I'll sort of make it up right now. It will just be BABA, and it will work if anyone wants to use it. I think it doesn't matter if it's capital or not. So. But I gave you my email address on that first slide, and it'll be on the last slide. And I answer emails fast, although with so much volume, it's getting a little more difficult. But I respond quickly by email if you ever need anything about anything. I try to make myself available. So it's on all of our services. We also do a couple of miscellaneous services. We will do your copyright registration for you. We will register your LLC. Yes, in the back.
In terms of traditional publishing companies, how is it changing the market?
It's a great question.
And also, I feel personally very good about it because if you're a small, publisher, those people who are well known get the visibility. So it affects the way democracy works and a comprehensive view of what is going on. So that's my first question. And then I have another one. Have you heard of beta readers? Beta readers. And who are they?
To answer your first question, and by the way, this is me with my three dogs, so we just moved. We were staying at a hotel in between selling one house and getting ready to move in. We hit them all in the wild. A fun thing to look at. So the proliferation of author publishers has changed the market, and it's changing for traditional publishers as well, because they are having to sell themselves to authors to explain the value that they would offer, and they're offering less and less value as a result too. There's so many books now out there that it's hard for any one book to do well. And so traditional publishers are now focusing most of their energy looking for people who already have platforms to help assist them with the marketing. And more traditional publishers are becoming less and less traditional. And sometimes they're starting to now charge an author to do their own editing or some services like that. I don't remember your second question, but I'll be happy to answer it afterwards. I just want to get a couple more people.
Yes. So, beta readers. If you'd like to come and talk to me, I'll talk to you about beta readers.
And we are at our we're at our time. So let's say thank you to Rob Price. Thanks for being with us today. And so our afternoon is all about membership and BAPA and getting your voice heard. And I would like to ask if there are people in the room who would rather we wait until 1 o'clock to start that because they have to dash out and get food and come back. Are there any people in that category? No? So if we were to start early, say at 12:40, would that be good?
Yeah?
Okay. That gives us time to grab some nibbles and eat and regroup. Okay? So I hope that you'll that most or all of you will be able to stay. Thank you.
Thank you.
You gonna hike on Monday?
No.
How come? Mike hasn't been hiking because his hip has been bothering him. He's going to start doing physical therapy for his hip. He got a minute above the last couple of months and he had family in town and he had a football problem. I'm going to go by it.